I am happy to share with you this walkthrough video of our 60% completed Parish Life Center. We are beginning that tour, if you will, through the connecting doorway from the parish school. So we begin by entering into what we call the connecting hall of the Parish Life Center. It connects the Parish Life Center and the parish school. Off of the connecting hallway, there are three entrances. The first entrance is from the bus parking lot, where the children every morning and every afternoon will encounter their buses. The second entrance into the connecting hallway is from the circle driveway in front of the Parish Life Center and the school. This is where the children in the mornings and the afternoon will enter and be picked up by their parents in the circle driveway. The third entrance is into the Parish Life Center itself, into what we call the East Hallway. The East Hallway goes from the connecting hall of the school to the exit toward the children's playground. The first feature on our left is the kitchen. And across from the kitchen is the servery room. It has a window and a connection to the great hall. It'll be used for meetings during the week and for serving in large events. Continuing down the east hallway, we have a cafeteria director and maintenance director offices. And we have the backstage area of the Great Hall. There is storage there and a ramp that leads up to the stage level and takes us out onto the stage. This is a 40-foot wide auditorium stage with a acoustical slanted ceiling, and the view into the Great Hall is quite impressive. The width and the depth of the hall is able to hold 600 people at round tables. There is ministry storage space off of this east hallway. And then we come to the family recreation area. It is two large rooms connected by a movable door. It looks out toward the children's playground.
And it is equipped with a multi-purpose flooring to accommodate light aerobics and many of the youth activities that take place on the floor. Across from the family recreation center is the storage room for the Great Hall. 60 round tables and 800 chairs to accommodate the large events in the Great Hall. There is a public restroom in the vestibule of the south entrance of the East Hall that looks out toward the children's playground and the athletic fields. So this will be a great accommodation for those who are playing on the fields and observing the athletics. We enter into the great and the main concourse. The main concourse goes all the way from the east end to the west, and it toward the tower entrance. And it is on the north side, open to these grand windows looking toward the church and the school. This main concourse is flooded with light, and it has three bays of seats with chairs and tables. Great place for gathering with people in for the Great Hall, etc. And it looks back toward the connecting hallway to the school. The Great Hall is adorned on the south side with three great bay windows with doors emptying out onto a grand patio. The west end of the main concourse brings us to the west connecting hallway. Goes from the tower entrance to the south entrance toward the ball fields and the parking lot to the south. This connecting hallway separates the Great Hall from the parish offices behind that purple wall board. At the north end near the tower entrance, there is a welcome and beverage center. And this will be just adjacent to the waiting area for the parish offices. So we enter into the parish offices. That plastic wall isn't there. And here is a reception window and a waiting area with furniture. The entrance door to the parish offices then. And we enter in. There's a small conference room there to the left. And then we come into the main office. There is workstations for four pastoral ministers or office workers. Back here, behind, a little bit secluded, is the bookkeeper. And these great windows with the cruciform window bars looks out toward the north, toward Wallings Road. There's a reception window. So this will be a great place for people to feel welcome and served. These great views toward the north, toward the church and the front of the school building and the circle driveway. Those cruciform windows are a feature of the architecture of the building. Going down the central hall of the offices, we find about 10 pastoral minister offices to accommodate all and the growing number of pastoral ministers. Those cruciform windows, they are grouped in threes, as everything in this architectural plan is. Across in the central feature of the parish offices is this beautiful conference room. It has telecommunication and Zooming, video capacity. It also has an entrance out to the west connecting hall. So in the evenings, parishioners can enter from both the tower entrance and the south entrance and enter in and participate in meetings in the conference room. Continuing down the central hallway of the parish offices, more parish ministers' offices, and we come around to a pastoral staff entrance. That empties out toward the patio. Behind south of the Great Hall, there is, of course, a small kitchenette with place for coats and a refrigerator for lunches to be stored for the parish staff. This pastoral staff entrance looks out at the patio of the Great Hall and toward the south in the practice fields, of the newly redone practice fields of our parish. These parish offices look out toward the south, and there's great parking there and driveways and the athletic fields, all regraded and ready for our students and our children, and with lighting included. So we head back up toward the main office, down back north on the central hallway. We enter out and to consider the tower entrance. This is the central architectural feature of the building. It is intended to reference the south entrance of the church building, what we call the chandelier entrance. It will be two stories high with lights, and it, like the chandelier entrance of the church, will be lighted on both of its stories and be a beacon for everybody who enters onto our parish property with the welcome of our parish ministry. This is on the circle driveway and where people will congregate and enter into the building. The windows on the main concourse then, looking down toward the east, those windows are intended to reference the entrance of our school building, so that this architecture and this building will fit into and complement our existing property. At the end of that main concourse, you see the inset there, the archway. The sculpture from the front of our current parish office building and the old convent is going to be placed in that connector to the school hallway and the connecting hallway to the school. So it brings us back to where we started, and you can see the tower entrance outside of that connecting hallway doorway, and it's all bringing us to the reminder that this is a great gift to our parish. We're going to be celebrating the dedication and the grand opening on August 1st. Bishop Edward Malesic will be presiding at the 11:30 a.m. Mass, and everyone is invited to a dedication ceremony afterwards and a public reception. Thank you for joining us on this tour, and God bless you, and God bless St. Albert the Great.